Good morning and welcome to yet another vlog. It's been a while. I don't know why I did that. Matt, cut that. Doing a lot of cleanup today, okay? We just took this down, and this was just pretty much the background of what I used to paint Octane's art piece that I did for him. And now it's ready to be sent to him. It's right there. Did you get that?
A little bit.
Okay, that's all you needed to do. Anyway, the CDL is moving to online, as you guys know. And it is one of those things where nobody could have predicted something like this happening. Nobody could have prepared for something like this. So we're setting up a LAN because the players are going to be competing out of here, except for Formal. Obviously, as you guys know, Formal lives in California, and for him to travel at this moment in time was gonna be a little bit too expensive, because the only way that I was gonna put Formal, okay, the only way that I was gonna be able to put Formal on a plane is if I bought him a private jet. And when I say I buy him a private jet, I mean rent him a private jet, okay? Just one-time use. He's driving back. I even told him I had to go pick him up. I said, I'll grab the Nissan Armada, the most comfortable car you're ever gonna be in, and I'm gonna go pick you up. 22 and a half hours to get to his house, and 22 and a half hours on the way back. 28 hours if we make a stop in El Paso, Texas, and go to a taco place called Taco Tote. I might prank somebody and say, yo, you wanna go get the best tacos in Texas? And when they say, yeah, I'm gonna get him in the car and I'm just gonna drive. What's he gonna do, jump out? Who am I gonna prank? I don't know. Leave a comment down below if you think that I should prank somebody and tell me who. Anyway, we have to go to storage. We have to go pick up a whole bunch of, actually not that many PlayStations or monitors, but we do need some because everything else has been spread out because of the amount of content that we've been creating out of the Hex Quarters up until the virus came along. But for the time being, we do need to prepare. Now, I've done a lot of preparation in order to, I had to get three internet lines, three separate internet lines, just as a preemptive attempt to make sure that competitive integrity maintains competitive. What I mean by that is that we won't be able to, we won't get hit offline. Okay, we have three, we've taken appropriate measures. I've had to cut a couple of deals with different people to make sure that everything's taken care of, and my internet provider, being the sweethearts that they are, have been very agreeable to make sure that that happens. Okay, it's time to go. Okay, what am I forgetting? Okay, so tables are here, chairs are here, monitors, two Xbox on PlayStations, and then we are good to go. Maddie, I'm driving, but you gotta come with because you gotta carry this stuff. As I was saying, the amount of stuff that we need to do, though, I mean, you guys have seen it before, right? Like, the second that this gets turned around, right now it's blank. I mean, obviously, Josef was working. Alan is doing what he's doing. But this, in this line, usually we have it here. Since we're only going to have one team, my team, our team, playing out of here, what I figured is that we won't set it up diagonally like this, but instead, we will face it this way. So there will be monitors, well, there'll be a table here, monitors facing that way, so the players are facing this way. That way we can just like pan over them, take pictures, do the creative stuff that we like to do when shooting b-roll and a whole bunch of stuff. I'm working on something very, very, very special, very cool here. This whole setup, thank you, Maddie, that whole setup is being put together because I have a very, very cool idea for a YouTube video that's gonna be forthcoming. And yeah, that's about it. Let's go meet up with Maddie, who is outside getting the Armada ready. And by that, I mean, you know, make it clean and stuff. Clean it a little bit. It's been such a long time. No one's here. This building is impossible to get into right now. You have to call security. Security then has to buzz you in, and then from after the buzz in, they have to put in the code in the computer to allow the elevator to work. It's crazy. Too much work. Safety first. It's time. You know, the bad thing about moving online is the fact that there are so many factors that need to be factored into the fact that there might be people who are going to try to derail this thing. The connectivity issue alone is going to be a little bit of a process, right? Because some people have better internet than others. We have excellent internet. We have three lines of excellent internet at the studio, as I just mentioned. Other people are playing from home. Formal's connectivity to Texas host or New York host, like, there's going to be a difference that shows in there. So although it won't be as clear and concise of a competitive nature, if that makes any sense, it won't be truly competitive. It is what we have. And what were we supposed to do? Not try? What were we supposed to do? Just sit around and not even give it a shot to keep this year alive on year one of the CDL? Absolutely not. We have always been really, really, really strong and self-sufficient in being able to put on shows and to keep the Call of Duty competitive spirit alive. No matter the limitations, no matter the lack of support, no matter anything, we've always had the will and the want to make things happen, right? And that's what we're doing right now. So me putting on a LAN for my Call of Duty team, our Call of Duty team, for your Chicago Huntsmen to compete, I used to do it for fun. We used to throw LAN events as preparation. Now this is serious. So you better believe that we're doing anything and everything that we can to make sure that everything is set up right. Activision sent us a whole bunch of little cameras that Matt is gonna put on every player station. I don't know how it's gonna be. There's a whole bunch of technical stuff that needs to happen because we're gonna have a coach. Okay, so coaches can't be in the same room or something along those lines, or they can only talk after the match. Same thing as now. Every single thing that has happened LAN is gonna have to happen here. There's going to be a referee on site or on the internet. I don't know how that's gonna work, but there's gonna be a referee looking at us the entire time to make sure that no team is doing any sort of kind of tomfoolery, okay? This is something that's serious. This is something that we, as I just said, have to make sure that it's a successful outing. So above anything else, competition aside, Call of Duty aside, we're here to entertain. And entertain we shall. The Eagle has landed. Operation storage unit has been completed. And we are now ready to head back to the studio. Two monitors, two PlayStations is all we needed. We did have a whole bunch of other stuff that we could have brought, but we're just gonna leave it there just simply because it doesn't make sense for us to bring it here. Now the true work begins. Maddie is gonna sit around, grab his little scissors and zip ties and get to work putting together a LAN that, you know, that the boys are gonna be competing on. He loves doing that, right, Maddie? You like doing that? That's a yes for Maddie. That is a yes. Look, I don't mind doing it either, but if I do it, then what's Matt gonna do? You know, it's the way that I see things and the way that I like to do stuff. Anyway, the good and the bad thing about everything that's happening right now is that everything has just become a little bit more uncomfortable. Like, obviously, like as I mentioned as we were walking in here, the fact that it is now a ghost town, it's crazy. It's an eerie feeling coming into Frisco Square, seeing the... into Frisco Square, seeing the amount of people that are no longer here, seeing how many people just don't show up anymore. Nirvana Food and Spirits, Nirvana Coffee, like it's all done. It's all blocked off. It's all empty. Like no one's here. And that is a sad, sad thing. The good thing is that because we're in the same building as a very, very big video game developer, we have security in place, which we sort of get to take advantage of. Matt needs to be buzzed in by security, then he needs to get permission to the elevator, and then once he's at the elevator, he has to go open our door. Like, there's a lot of steps that happen in order to get to the hex quarters, which I like, personally. Safety first. Oh my God, look at this. It is completely and utterly empty. Maddie. Take your time. All right, Matt, let's get this bread. Ugh. Damn, you need to hit the gym. I think we all do, Matt. No worries there. Yeah, put those two. What's in here? This has been in here for a long time. Oh, some hoodies. Leave a like on the video if you want me to send you a hoodie. And a comment. Alright, sorry, Matt. My bad. Don't yell at me. Yeah. Right this way, Maddie. You got it? Don't drop it. You put a scratch on those things, it's scratching your butt. Hey, Maddie. Alright, Matt, so this is what I was thinking. Alright? Since we usually put everything like...
In the middle?
Yeah. I say we put it horizontally. Monitors facing this way, players facing this way. That way we can catch B-roll of them. Let's pretend that Alan here... Let's pretend that Alan wasn't as handsome as he is, and that's Scumpy. He needs to be facing this way, monitor that way. That way we can get cool B-roll of them. You know, like this.
Yeah.
You get it?
Yeah, that was dope.
No, shake the cam. Oh, never mind. Just like that, the setup has already been created and done and everything's good. The boys are now here. They're doing some, a couple of tests.
Go to your setup. Move in Alec and Dylan.
Oh, shit.
What's
happening?
We're doing the vetoes right now. You know, I'm trying to get a listen in, but they pulled Troy away from us, so we're going back.
Huh?
It's chilly in here, my God, dude.
So Scump feels like it's a little bit too cold in here, so I'm gonna do whatever I can to turn the heat up because it is cold. If not, we're gonna have to give him some a heater, a space heater, that is. All right, let's return to the competition. So right now, Matt Formal is playing from home because obviously we're not gonna make him travel in this climate. And by this climate, I mean the current state that we are going through. I will say this though, I did offer to get him a private jet, so there's no excuses there. Depending on his performance today, we'll determine whether or not we leave him there or we bring him out here. Get him a nice Airbnb, sanitized, pre-sanitized. Maybe stay at my house. If he's cleared, of course, from the thing. I'm gonna get him. He hasn't been abiding by the rules of 6 feet of distance, social distancing, and otherwise, then obviously he can't come to my house.
Who bans first in the Dom?
How about we just don't move to that?
Yo, Troy.
All right, we just finished an 0-3. It wasn't even miraculous. How do I explain it? It was glorious the way that this 0-5 reverse sweep came about. Is that called the reverse sweep when you 0-5 when you come back from 0? It's a comeback. It was a crazy comeback, and to have Envoy finish it with a ninja defuse, that was incredible. And there's no better way to end a game like that. Just like there's no better way to end this vlog. Thank you so much for tuning in. If you guys enjoyed the video, please do not leave without leaving a like. Having said that, and with that said, I'm going to see you guys too. I'm lying. I don't know when I'm going to see you guys, but better believe that one day, out of nowhere, it's just going to appear like crop circles in signs and all that stuff. I'm just going to appear somewhere, and it's going to be... I'm back to normal. El Chefe, coming back. I finally got the will and the want to start recording some cooking videos. And that is what I will be doing. So thank you so much for tuning in. I'll see you when I see you. At the same damn time, I guess. At the same damn time.